What a perfect day in my kingdom!
Princess?
What? How dare you disturb my creative process?
Sorry, bits of a problem, though. The people are revolting.
Oh, I know! They don't even shower!
No, I mean they're in revolt. They want your head on a stick.
But why? I offer them everything! Singing, dancing, romance, what?
I mean, you're doing a very good job. I just think, you know, look at children with disabilities.
Ah, yes, the crippled children.
I feel like, in other kingdoms, children with disabilities are taken care of.
Ah, you mean...
No, I mean, they're offered actual services. Look at Ireland, for example. Lorna, tell her.
Welcome to this workshop on enabling and supporting the Progressing Disability Service. The Progressing Disability Service, PDS, is a national programme to reorganise children's disability services. You, the managers of the 96 teams, have gathered today to discuss and share information on making this transformative innovation happen. Today we will discuss policy and strategy. A compelling view for the third horizon, a new policy for the Children's Disability Services. It will see a more equitable service that will be needs-led rather than by the child's diagnosis. Children will access services nearer to their home in a timely manner. A family-centred approach will be adopted in all cases and parents' input will be valued. The first horizon, the current practice at the moment looks a little bit different. Each county is at a different stage of reconfiguration. Thousands of children are waiting assessments of their needs. Thousands more are on waiting lists for therapies and treatments. There is a higher than predicted amount of children on each Children's Disability Network team. Children are currently aging out of services. There is a reduction in service provision due to COVID-19 and the recent HSE cyber attack. There is finite and limited resources allocated to each Children's Disability Network team. The strategy for you will be to keep the plane in the air while redesigning it. Here are some tips to bear in mind while this transformative innovation is taking place. You need to be aware that longer-term transition from a dominant pattern, H1, to another, such as RH3 vision, takes time. You will need to notice instances where this transition is taking place on some even small scales as evidence that the culture is changing. The landscape is often full of optimism for change, but it can often be a decade away, so bear time in mind. The policy goal is a radical one, for a whole new Children's Disability Network. Therefore, a wholesale shift to a new H3 will not work. The H1 system currently in place will have to exist in tandem with the H3 until a new viable pattern of renewal and culture emerges. It is your responsibility as managers to be aware of these dynamics and that the old system will exist within the new. You must be hospice workers for a dying culture and midwives for the new. It is also your responsibility to share information and push the H3 vision, along with government policy and strategy, for PDS to succeed. You must discuss and manage dilemmas. If you are willing to work creatively through conflict and not settle for compromise, then you will reach a resolution zone, where you can really enjoy the best of both worlds. You will also need to be aware how to budget for transformative innovation.
World tour, we're on a world tour of... Where is this place again?
I told you, we're in Ireland.
Ireland? Oh yes, the next step of my musical extravaganza. Move over, Enya. Only time.
here to learn about the progressing distance. That sounds boring! We're here to sing! We're here to learn about the tree horizon.
Tree horizons? There's only one horizon! Oh, can't you count, idiots?
Look, it's more of a figure of...
Cormac, can you just tell her?
Hello, my name is Cormac Duff, and today we'll be discussing the Progressing Disability Service through the Tree Horizons framework. Tree Horizons looks at patterns of thinking over time. Horizon 1 is our business as usual. It's our current treatment for children with disability in the community. Horizon 2 is a disruptive innovation, a change to our delivery of service. And Horizon 3 is a bold new vision of our future for children with disabilities. Let's look at the issues with Horizon 1 at present. Firstly, our system is hard to access with a confusing referral process for parents and doctors. There are long waiting lists to different organizations in different hospitals and community locations. There are different teams leading to siloed healthcare workers that don't communicate with each other and don't work with each other. This leads to disjointed care for our patients, under-resourced team, and unfair treatment based on geography rather than need. This relies on the private system rather than the public. There's a lack of overall strategy, there's a lack of accountability, and there's lack of oversight for the quality of care for our children. Let's look at the good points of the system that we'd like to keep. Firstly, each family has a key worker on the multidisciplinary team, someone they can speak to in a time of need. We have strong input from volunteer organizations and disability advocate groups. Now, let's look at H3, signs of a new vision for the future. First, there is a strong desire for change in thinking from families, advocacy group, staff, and unions. There's political support and a successful pilot in HSE Midwest. It involves shifts in thinking from diagnosis-based to needs-based. It focuses on intervention with additional resources for children, which are delivered locally by integrated teams working together. It focuses on families rather than systems, and it leads to standardized care across the country. This innovation is, of course, the Progressing Disability Service, which offers a network reconfiguration, making 96 children's disability networks. Staff will be reallocated to these networks and put on community teams. There will be clinical governance, as each team will have a manager who will supervise care. The managers will be part of operational management groups across the country, and quality of care will be audited. Let's look towards the future. In future, each child will have the same team from birth until 18 years. They'll be in one network, one team, in one convenient location close to home. Services will be fast and local and well-resourced. Services will be needs-based rather than diagnosis-based, and they'll be continuous with integrated care from early intervention to school age. Teams will be accountable to a high-quality standard across the country. Care will have equitable access, and it will be family-centered, holistic, with collaborative goal setting between clinicians and families. Thank you.
Oh, it's so cold! My nipples are like icicles! Why did you bring me here?
I brought you to Alaska so we could learn about the Nuka community health.
I don't care, I wasn't asking! I just want to be warm! Wait. I'm going to cut you open.
Wait, what?
I'm going to cut you open and sleep inside your entrails like Leo DiCaprio in The Revenant.
Wait, that sounds horrific. Wait, what?
Let me cut you like a fish!
No! Anthony, help!
Hi, my name is Anthony Smith, and I'd like to talk to you briefly about two healthcare systems. One is Nuka of Alaska versus the PDF of the HSE. With Nuka of Alaska, you see that they have a 97% customer owner satisfaction, 95% employee satisfaction, and they are in 75th to 90th percentile in many HEDIS measures, which is healthcare effectiveness data and information set. What makes them successful? They have strong relationships between primary care teams and patients, known as customer owners. They have completely redesigned and transformed their healthcare system, including workforce development, compliance, human resources, and finance, also focusing on organization-wide relationship building and shared decision-making. They have the belief that multidimensional wellness can only occur effectively in a relationship-based system of care by and for the customer owner when, where and how they want it. How do they do it? They have locally based advisory groups, which meet once a month, and they include the multidisciplinary teams and the customer owners. The customer owners have actual access to management and the government structure of the company, and there's the use of surveys, focus groups, and telephone hotlines to ensure that people can give feedback that is heard and acted upon. If we look at the PDS, which is Progressing Disability Services for Children and Young People, we see that presently some good services exist for children with disabilities and their families, but there are still large gaps. Children with intellectual disabilities have access to a service, but none for children with physical disabilities. Access to services should be based on the child's needs rather than just a diagnosis. Children and families should have services available wherever they live. What's your vision? To have early access to the services children need, fairness in providing services, and families, healthcare services, and schools working together to support children in developing their potential. The way forward, many children with delays in their development can have their needs met by their local primary care services. Children's Disability Network teams will provide services for all children with more significant needs and will require a team of professionals working together. This will be regardless of the child's disability diagnosis or where he or she goes to school. Parents and healthcare professionals, instead of trying to find their way through a maze of services, will easily be able to find that their child should be referred. How the program has been organized, there's a national working group which guides and oversees the program. There are local implementation groups, representatives of services and parents working out how services can be reorganized to achieve the end goal. What stage has been reached? Because of the way services have developed over the decades, each part of the country is at a different stage of reconfiguration. When this program is completed, every child with complex needs in the country will have access to a service. Thank you for listening. I just want to share briefly about the Transformative Innovation Permission Slip. This is great to give to every member of your team, every employee on every level, and get them to ask themselves these questions. Is it good for me and the people I serve and care about? Is it legal, ethical, and in tune with my professional values? Am I willing to be responsible and be accountable for it? Can I find a friend that is willing to join me? Does it embody the third horizon at present? Can it get started with little or no additional finance? If your answer is yes to all these questions, then anyone can be a part of the vision and moving the company forward. Thank you.
I'm so happy I found this warm log cabin. And I'm happy I escaped with only minor lacerations. I guess we all learned a valuable lesson about supporting and enabling innovation.
We sure did.
And for my first Kingdom's innovation,
yes,
I will create,
yes,
an ice palace.
Ice palace, why?
So I can sing, let it go, let it go.
Oh no.
Can't hold me back anymore.
Megan, stop.
Let it go, let it go. Turn away and slam the door.
No.
I can't tell what he's going to say. Let the storm rage on. The cold never bothered me anyway.